And we're going to take a look at some of the highlights from earlier on tonight. You
and
see
the bantamweights,
two undefeated fighters, rather. Jornell A1 Lugo fighting out of Connecticut from West Palm Beach, Florida, taking on Dirty Harry, Harris Bonfiglio, who was the Taekwondo specialist, but tonight it was Lugo's night.
Lugo, beautiful sidesteps, throwing the lead hook. Great technique. And I tell you what, he's solid foundation, really is.
Lugo talked about the skills that pay the bills, and he showed them off tonight. That knee to the midsection was what really did it. Softened up on Figlio. Referee stops it promptly. A1 with win number two to remain unbeaten. Nice technique there by Lugo.
Yeah, it was to me, that was a grappler versus a striker. And we all know what happens if you can defend a grappler.
Featherweight action, Pete Rogers Jr. from Norwich, Connecticut, coming in here, taking on relentless Robbie LaRue, making a comeback after 5 years off. He had just fought in March. Rogers had the fans on his side, but it was Robbie LaRue who came in there, scored the upset victory when Pete Rogers unable to continue due to injury. Take a look at this technique on the ground here, William.
Yeah, that was a real upset. I didn't expect that to happen.
William Knight, of course, there forced to tap out after the injury. LaRue improved to 6-5, over 500 for the first time in quite some time, earning his first victory in 5 years. Tough luck loss for Pete Rogers, who dropped to 4-5. And speaking of upsets, in the lightweight division, we had the young up-and-comer Jesse Kozakowski from Waterbury, Connecticut, the submission specialist, taking on Reggie Merriweather. 27 pro bouts on his resume, never count out a champion.
I've seen this too often where a guy who's undefeated comes in and fights a guy with a lot of skill. You've been there before.
Reggie Merriweather, yeah.
Yeah, so at the end of the day, it's like, what do you got to lose?
Showed that veteran experience to improve to 14-14, and then our heavyweight co-main event. Pat, this one was all action from start to finish. We saw Jurley Broenstrup and the Black Trunks get up early from some of the assault from Parker Porter. Porter actually had a turn up in the end to really survive this fight.
He did, because Broenstrup did a great job coming back in the second and then quite a bit of the third round, you know, with great endurance. But that lead hook there clipped him on the chin, didn't see it coming, and down he went.
Parker Porter improving to 8-5 with a big win, the third knockout of his career, taking down the 23-fight vet Broenstrup in our co-main event. And then, of course, our headliner, our world title bout in the welterweight division. It was the Brazilian bad boy, Vinicius de Jesus, fighting out of Stamford, Connecticut, taking on Chris Lozano, the multiple Bellator veteran with 14 fights on his record. This one, again, all action. De Jesus, I thought, William, did a much nicer job in this fight than he did the night he actually won the title.
Yeah, so in this fight, it was like he had a point to prove. One guy coming in off of a long layoff, and then this guy just fought earlier this year on a card I should have fought on.
That's right. You saw in round three, De Jesus with the relentless attack. The referee jumps in, stops it. De Jesus defending the title in his first pro, or rather his first title defense. And like we talked about, Pat, now he is finally the champion. And of course, don't forget, we're gonna be back in Rhode Island October 25th at Twin River Casino Hotel for CES 59, the return of unbeaten welterweight prospect John Gotti III. Always exciting when John Gotti gets inside that cage. That one's gonna be fun to watch. Always remember, go to CESMMA.com for your tickets. Tickets and group packages are available both on the website and by calling 401-724-2253. That's CES 59 coming up soon.